Today, I'm showing you how to make these clear edible domes out of isomalt. To make these, you will of course need isomalt, which is just a sugar substitute that's often used for sugar work. It comes in a few different forms. I have a powdered version here and a granular version, which is a little bit more popular. I'll link to where you can buy some below, but it's really easy to find online, and also at any sort of specialty pastry or cooking shops. To make our domes, all we have to do is get a bit of isomalt into a pot, then add in a touch of water. We just want enough water to make the isomalt look a little bit like wet sand. Get this onto medium-high heat and let it melt. You can swish the pot around like this to get any unmelted bits, but you shouldn't really need to stir this as it tends to melt pretty evenly. When your isomalt has reached 338 degrees Fahrenheit, remove it from the heat. Straight off the heat, the isomalt is way too hot to work with, so we need to let it cool to between 220 degrees Fahrenheit and 240 degrees Fahrenheit. Then take a circular metal cutter and dip it into the isomalt, and pull the cutter up slowly so that you're left with a clear film over the bottom. Use your fingers to gently pull the isomalt downwards. I'm just using my bare hands, but you can of course use gloves. I find that dishwashing gloves are actually a great substitute for traditional sugar work gloves, and you're more likely to have those on hand. When the isomalt has hardened, which happens pretty quickly, flip the cutter over and set it to the side. To remove the domes from the cutters, use a blowtorch to heat up a small knife. You need to get this really, really hot or it won't work properly. We want it to be so hot that it cuts clean through the isomalt by melting it instantly with essentially no resistance, or we will shatter our domes. After you've done a few of these, make sure to wipe down your knife or the sugar on the blade will catch fire, and then you're going to be wandering around your kitchen with a flaming knife. Please try to avoid this if you can. You can use these to cover little plated desserts. I used an isomalt dome on this dessert here from the Best Laid Scheme series, which I will link to below if you want to check it out. I wanted it to be like an edible snow globe, so I think it turned out pretty nicely. These definitely aren't something I would make all the time, but occasionally, for a showstopper kind of dessert, they're really cool and fun to smash. If you like this video and want to see more content like this, consider subscribing and feel free to connect with us elsewhere at chefstudio_.